So the answer to this question, unfortunately, is sometimes. Don't you hate that? It's pretty frequent that I get people telling me like, hey, I want to get a nice smooth finish. Here's my plan. I'm going to throw down 10 coats of paint. I'm going to wet sand between each of those coats, make sure everything's nice and smooth to like 2000 grit before I continue. And then by the end, it should be glassy smooth, right? Well, don't do that. So like I said, the answer is sometimes. For example, let's say you're throwing on some polyurethane. Well, polyurethane builds in layers. We know that, right? You're going to want to probably put on 3 coats maybe at a time, which means you're not going to sand between those 3 coats. You put one on, wait 10 to 15 minutes typically, put another one on, wait 10 to 15 minutes, put another one on. Then you stop, all right? You don't want to build up 8 layers of paint in a session like that because the stuff on the bottom won't dry properly. The stuff on the top, which is exposed to air, will, and you'll end up with this soft, impressionable coat of paint where, like, if you put your guitar down or whatever on a towel, you end up with a texture in it. So you can put your 3 coats on, you don't have to sand between those, but then you're gonna wanna let that dry for a day or two, and then in order to be able to add more if you so choose, then you need to sand so that the new paint has something to stick to. So while you're doing that 10 to 15 minute gap between coats, you've got your chemical adhesion, the paint's still just a little bit wet, there's enough solvent in there that the other stuff bonds to it. Once it's dried for that 24 to 48 hours, then you need to scuff it so you get mechanical adhesion. So even within that one example, we've got yes and no. Sometimes you need to sand between coats, sometimes you don't. Another frequent one is lacquer. People are always saying, hey, you need to sand between your coats of lacquer. Well, not really. Unlike the polyurethanes and the enamels and stuff like that, lacquer doesn't build in layers. Lacquer melts into itself. It also doesn't cure, it only dries. So lacquer doesn't actually change composition per se, if I'm using that term correctly, when it sets up. What happens is the solvents evaporate and it hardens, but it's still the same thing. If you put lacquer thinner back on top of lacquer, it dissolves again. Whereas if you take the thinner of the solvent from polyurethane and put that back on top, you can't then make polyurethane that's sprayable again and reshoot it. Lacquer, technically you could. So what does this mean as far as sanding goes? It means that, I mean, you can sand between coats. You can spray a coat, wait a day, sand it flat. If there's some imperfections or too much orange peel or something in there and you decide you need to get it smooth again, feel free to do that. But if you don't sand between coats, if you just wipe it off, clean it, the next layer will actually melt into the layer before it. So lacquer is one of the only types of paint where you can spray right over a gloss finish as long as it's the same thing. If you've got a gloss lacquer on there, you can throw another coat of gloss on the next day and that'll stick. Now we've definitely covered this before, but just so you know, based on my first example there, even if you are sanding in between, with lacquer it's fine. You can go as fine as you want because again, it's gonna bond chemically by melting together. But with everything else, you don't wanna be sanding with 2000, 3000 grit, anything like that between coats. It's too much like gloss. It's too damn smooth, all right? You need something for that next layer of paint to bite into. So you're gonna wanna go probably more like an 800 or 600 grit. Right before your clear coat, I go with 800. Between coats of color, I usually do 6. 1,000 tops, I wouldn't go that high if it were me, but hey, everybody's got their own preferences. And a lot of people don't agree with me. I had one guy say you have to polish your paint before you clear coat it. He was an idiot, but he did say that. So I hope that clears that up. Now you know, hopefully if you need to sand between your coats, you're gonna wanna do a little bit of research into the type of paint that you're using if you're not sure. I've already covered lacquer. Polyurethane and enamel do pretty much the same thing, and acrylics generally behave a lot like those as well. Not so much with the lacquer, it's kind of a different setup. Yeah. Those are kind of the main ones that you're gonna find on in a guitar-related context at least anyway, which is probably why most of you are watching me. So as always, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and that it cleared a couple things up for you or you found it entertaining or whatever. If you did like it, please feel free to give it a thumbs up so it's easier for other people to find. Thank you, YouTube, for making it so that that's predicated on that. And of course, subscribe if you haven't already. Again, thanks for watching. Have a good one and I will see you next time.